In the 1950s, a new generation of infantry vehicles emerged called APCs. APC means Armored Personnel Carrier. The United States Army's M113 was typical of this type of vehicle. They were fully tracked with more mobility than half-track vehicles and were fully armored, giving the troops more complete protection.
I think more than anything, it was lessons of the war, as well as the fact that you are looking at trying to come up with an armor envelope that's going to protect your crewmen and your infantry from shrapnel, from air bursts, that sort of thing. That gives you a complete armored envelope. Going to the full track gave them a much better off-road capability than the half-track design did. And let's face it, with full track versus half-track on road, you really don't have that much difference in capability. But with the wheel, you're subject to tires getting punctured, and to the fact that you're going to have less off-road capability without the full track. So the decision was made to go to the full track design.
The basic role of APCs such as the M113 is to bring the infantry squad forward with the tanks and then dismount the squad and let them fight on foot in the traditional infantry fashion. The M113 was the most widely produced American armored vehicle of all times, with over 70,000 manufactured. It is used not only for transporting infantry, but in many combat support roles as well, such as its use as an ambulance to carry wounded troops. The M113 is also used as the basis for tank-hunting missile vehicles, armed with the TOW missile. The original version, like these Saudi TOW vehicles, have the missile launcher completely exposed. The more recent version, the M901 ITV improved TOW vehicle that we see here, has the TOW missiles mounted in a special armored hammerhead launcher, so that the crew stays protected within the armored hull of the vehicle. When ready to fire, the missile launcher can be elevated above the roof, allowing the crew to position the vehicle behind a hill for further protection. This version of the M113 is likely to serve on in the U.S. Army long after the basic infantry carrier has been replaced by more modern vehicles. The M113 has been widely exported around the world. In the recent Gulf War, it not only served with the United States Army, but with the armies of other coalition forces, including the Egyptian and Saudi armies.